Hello friends, you are watching ERUDIRE PLUS, the professional CAD/CAM solution provider. This channel provides basics of finite element analysis and computer-aided mechanical engineering design and analysis using CAD-related software. Let's get started.
Hello friends, today we'll show design analysis and optimization of a connecting rod using SolidWorks. Here in this case, we have to select the right-hand side, that means right-hand side cylindrical portion should be fixed, and left-hand side on this cylindrical portion we have to apply a pressure of 50 MPa. After design analysis, we have to go for optimization, that means we have to minimize the mass, and by the same time we have to fix that value of factor of safety. In normal design analysis, we will find the value of stress, and that same stress value we have to keep fixed, right? Okay. So we are starting our design analysis. Model is already made in the beginning using SolidWorks program. So we are starting now analysis part. Starting from simulation, new study, the static structure 1, so green check. Now we have to apply material to this connecting rod. It will come from part, apply any material. Let's provide ASTM A36 steel, which is having modulus of elasticity is 2E5 and Poisson's ratio 0.26. Apply and close. Material property is given, right? Next part is we have to fix the right part cylindrical portion. This part we have to fix it. That can be provided from fixed geometry. We select the rightmost part here inside the cylindrical portion. And okay, that means right part is selected and it is fixed. Now next part is you have to apply a pressure of 50 MPa on the left hand side here. External load, pressure, apply, it will be 50 MPa, right? 50, and unit will be Newton per millimeter square. Then pressure is applied. Now the last part, that is mesh and run. Is going on. Let's see the result. Okay, the thing is its modulus of elasticity is equal to 250 MPa, and the stress value, maximum stress developed, is equal to 1.78 into 8, that is 178 MPa, right? For better understanding, we can change this one in MPa unit, like any definition. Change the one stress unit as Newton per millimeter square or MPa. Green check. Okay. Now see the things here. Yield strength is 250 MPa and maximum one unit stress developed equal to 178 MPa. That is model is safe. By the same time, we can check the factor of safety. Factor of safety will be equal to yield stress divided by working stress, that is 250 divided by 1.78. Definitely it will be 1.34 something else. Let's see. We can change the value from result advisor also. We plot factor of safety. Green check is showing 1.398. That means approximately 1.4 is the factor of safety. And maximum factor of safety is equal to 1.12 × 10^11. It is very high. Actually, this wastage of material, but we cannot avoid this one in this case, right? You can see maximum stress is on the red portion. You can see the stress value at different portions also. Why? This probe. If you see the probe, if you click anywhere, it will show the stress value at different positions. These are the stress value at different positions. Now, we are not bothered about that one. Our task is to have the same factor of safety and minimize the mass, right? How much is the factor of safety? Minimum factor of safety is equal to 1.398. So in optimization case, what we'll do is we'll take minimum factor of safety equal to 1.4, and in that case we have to minimize the mass. Okay, then we're starting out design optimization. You will start it from this down static one, then with the right button of mouse you can start create new design study. Now while creating new design study, what we have to do is we have to select some specific parameters which are responsible for minimizing the mass at the same time minimizing the stress value also, right? In this case we can see definitely that length can be reduced, the thickness can be reduced to minimize the mass, but we have some constraint, that is we cannot go beyond these things for design constraint, because this connecting rod should be fixed with something else in the assembly, right? So we are restrained to remove the length, we are restrained to change the length, at the same time we are restrained to change the inner diameters of both these cases, but we can change the outer diameters also, right? Let's see to do this. Now while changing this parameter, we have to start from these variables here, variables, then add parameters. Now here, if we click any dimension, that will be considered as the what is an optimization parameter, right? First of all, we told that we want to reduce the mass, then this thickness will play a very important role. If we reduce the thickness, it will reduce the mass definitely. So select this thickness first. We can go ahead name as thickness. Next one, what can we do is we can change the outer diameters, right? Inner diameter we cannot change it. We are restrained to do this one. So this one will be fixing with something else. So OD we can fix it, right? Okay. Now OD, can write down OD1 is equal to 90. Now next one, what can we change again? Another we can change that is OD of the this right hand side, 60, OD2. These two, that is we have selected three parameters for design optimization. Okay, let's select this. Okay, now the parameters you have to take into consideration. So we'll drag it. Thickness is already given with the range of 10 millimeter to 30 millimeter. These ranges are actually different ranges. If we like, we can change these ranges also. OD2 range is 30 millimeter to 90 millimeter. Then again, we'll select the OD1. Its default range is 45 millimeter to 135 millimeter. Let's start with the default values. If the design is failing, we can change these values. We can change this. Default values also, right? Next part is we have to reduce the mass, or we can say we have to fix the factor of safety to some specific values, right? How much you want factor of safety, but we want something before how much was the stress. We can see before it was stress value was how much. You can see stress value and factor of safety, how much it was. Before factor of safety was 1.39. So in our optimization case, our task will be to have the factor of safety more than 1.4, right? Again, we are going to design study one. Okay. Now, to fix the factor of safety, we have to start from the constraint. Add sensor. Now, we have to change the mass properties to simulation data. And instead of stress, we have to check it to factor of safety. Great, check. Now the value of the factor of safety to be defined here, right? It should be more than 1.4, right? Should be greater than 1.4. Okay. Now the final goal. Final goal is to minimize the mass. Again, for this one, we have to start with these goals, then add sensor. Here, mass code is already there, then you have to select the mass and select the object. It will show the object mass, how much it is. It is 181.5 gram. right? This is the correct mass. Our task is to minimize the mass, right? So, grade check. And here, in the goals, you can see mass to be minimized. We have the goal, mass to be minimized, right? Let's see here, we have got 27 numbers of active scenario. That means 27 numbers of iterations will be going on, and each iteration will calculate stress value and mass value. By the same time, it will calculate a factor of safety, right? So this is okay. We can go for design study, optimum design study, run the solution. It is running. Number two is going on right now, and two scenarios have failed. That means design optimization could not be done in two cases. Now we can see one thing. When design optimization is going on different parameters or different ranges of these values, the drawing or the dimension of the model is also changing. The optimization study is about to be finished, still going on. Out of 29, 25 has already been completed. Maybe a few minutes more. Okay, optimization achieved, right? You can see this is the drawing. So finally, we have got the final drawing or final dimension. As the initial thickness was 20 millimeter and the final optimum thickness is 10 millimeter. Outer diameter was 60 millimeter. In this case, it was same, it was not reduced. OD was 90 millimeter. Now optimum value is 135 millimeter, and minimum factor of safety was 1.39. Now it has been improved 2.23. It is very high. It is better one. It is good solution. And mass, initial mass was 181.5 gram. Now the final mass is 148 gram. So we have optimized the mass. We have reduced the mass. By the same time, we have improved the factor of safety also. It is a better design, right? You can see the thickness is reduced, by the same time mass is minimized and factor of safety also improved. Better factor of safety means it is not prone to failure easily, right? If the factor of safety is very less, it has a tendency to fail easily. But by the same time, factor of safety is very high is also not acceptable. If it is very high, then it is wastage of material. In this case, factor of safety is equal to 2.23. is good enough. Okay, so we have achieved our goals, and this is all about our design analysis and optimization using SolidWorks. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like, please subscribe and share, and if you have any kind of doubts, please write to me. Thank you so much for watching this video.